हेलो एंड हाय टू एवरीवन, वंस अगेन मोस्ट वेलकम टू माय मनीष्टा यूट्यूब चैनल। फ्रेंड्स, इन प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैव सिमुलेटेड अ सिंगल फेज हाफ वेव रेक्टिफायर सर्किट। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू सिमुलेट अ थ्री रेजिस्टेंस कनेक्टेड इन सीरीज एंड आल्सो आई एम गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट द वोल्टेज एंड करंट इन ईच रेजिस्टेंसेज। एज वी नो दैट वेन रेजिस्टेंसेज आर कनेक्टेड इन सीरीज एंड देयर विल बी अ सिंगल करंट विल बी फ्लो इन दिस सर्किट, बट ड्यू टू कनेक्टेड इन कैस्केड मोड ईच रेजिस्टेंसेज विल हैव डिफरेंट डिफरेंट वोल्टेज अक्रॉस इट। इफ देयर विल बी ऑल डिफरेंट वैल्यूज ऑफ रेजिस्टेंसेज कनेक्टेड इन कैस्केड मोड। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द वीडियो ऑफ सिमुलेशन ऑफ थ्री रेजिस्टेंस कनेक्टेड इन कैस्केड मोड एंड ऑल्सो टू फाइंड आउट द वोल्टेज एंड करंट इन ईच रेजिस्टेंसेज। First of all, I have to select three resistances. So I am going to select three resistances from here. And I am going to connect three resistances in series or in cascade mode. So by default the values of these resistances are shown as 1 kilo ohm. So I am going to change the values of these resistances, like 20 ohm, 40 ohm, 100 ohm. So also I need a voltage source, like a voltage power source. So I am going to select a DC voltage source from here. This is a DC power supply. By default the value of this voltage source is shown as 5 volt. So I am going to change this voltage of about 10 volt. You can select different types of voltage. So after selecting three resistances like 20 ohm, 40 ohm and 100 ohm and a voltage power supply of about 10 volt, now I have to make a connection. So I am connecting a wire. All wires should be properly connected. In every simulation circuit, ground connection should be done. So I am going to ground it to this circuit with the ground potential. So finally this circuit completed. Now this circuit shows that three resistances like R1, R2 and R3 of values 20 ohm, 40 ohm and 100 ohm respectively are connected in cascade mode or in series mode with a 10 volt power supply. So in this problem I have to find out the voltage across each resistances and also I have to find out the current flowing through this circuit. To find out the voltage in each resistances, we have to select a voltmeter across these resistances. So I am going to select a voltmeter to find out the voltage dropped across each resistances. So voltmeter should be connected across these resistances. So this circuit is ready for simulation, and to find out the values across these resistances in terms of voltage form, we have to run this simulation. I have to click on this run simulator option. After clicking the run simulation, this simulation loading will be started. This second timing second shows that simulation is started, and to see the graph of these values, I have to click on split portion. To check the values across these resistances, we have to simply pause the circuit. And also to check the graphical values, have to analyze these values. By default, the graphical values is setted by default a minimum voltage value of about 1 volt. As I select a 10 volt DC power supply to this circuit, so I'm going to select a minimum values of about 0 volt and the maximum value of about 10 volt. Again, I have to start this run simulation. This graph shows that a voltage across the 20 ohm resistance is about 1.25 volt, and the voltage across this 40 ohm resistance is about 2.5 volt, and also the voltage across this 100 ohm resistance is about 6.25 volt. If you want to see the full graphical values, then you have to click on this grapher point. So this is the full graphical response of this simulation. To see the circuit with grapher response, simply I have to click on this split portion. In this graph, this green line shows that the value across 20 ohm resistance. This blue line shows the voltage value across this 40 ohm resistance, and this black line shows that the value across this 100 ohm resistance. As we know that when three resistance of different values are connected in cascade or series mode, then there will be a different voltage drop across it, and in this circuit there will be a single current which will flow in this circuit. To also find out the current value in this circuit, simply I have to connect a ammeter in series with these resistances. So I am going to connect a ammeter to find out the current flows in this circuit. Simply I have to click on ammeter or current portion, and this should be connected in series with these resistances. I have to again click on run simulator option. Again new simulation will be started. The value of current in this circuit shows that there is a 62.5 milliampere current is flowing in this circuit. To check the current grapher value in this grapher response, simply I have to click on this grapher portion. This analysis shows that by default the minimum value of this current is setted like 60 milliampere and the maximum value is setted on 70 milliampere. I have to select a minimum value like 0 milliampere and the maximum value of about 90 milliampere. Again, I have to start the run simulation. The current response is showing in this graph, which is of about 62.500 milliampere. So finally, the conclusion of this simulation will be, if three resistances like 20 ohm, 40 ohm and 100 ohm are connected in cascade or in series mode, with 10 volt DC power supply, then voltage across 20 ohm resistance will be 1.25 volt and the voltage across 40 ohm resistance will be 2.5 volt and the voltage across this 100 ohm resistance will be 6.25 volt. And also there will be a 62.500 milliampere current in this circuit. So this solution is done. Thank you for watching.